Hello, it's Joni from Twinkl. Let me show you some fun and creative ways that we can use this resource. Get two large bowls and fill one with warm water. You will also need at least one sponge and maybe some cloth. If you like, you can add in a little bit of washing up liquid, and children can whisk it round to make the water nice and bubbly. Now, challenge children to transfer the water from one bowl to the other using the sponges or cloth. Does it work well if we just dip the sponge in? What happens if we squeeze the sponge underneath the water? Does this collect more water into the sponge? This is a great opportunity to help develop children's thinking skills and vocabulary as you talk to them about what is happening and why. Compare the different sponges and material to see which one seems to hold the most water, which is the easiest to use. What happens if we dip the big sponge? What happens if we give the big sponge a really big squeeze? Does the big sponge hold the most water? Children will probably notice that the water is getting more and more bubbly. Can children completely fill the smaller bowl? Perhaps you could place the two bowls further apart from each other. Can children run back and forth between the two, transferring the water using the sponges? Is this more difficult? Are there any ways we can stop too much water dripping onto the ground? You could repeat the activity, but this time instead of using bubbles, you could use a little bit of food colouring. And instead of sponges and material, you could try some different pots, pans, jugs, and so on. Encourage children to predict which objects will transfer the water the best. Will this spoon be any good? How quickly can we transfer the water using the spoon? What about this fork? Why isn't the fork working? Encourage children to enjoy just playing with and investigating the water and the different utensils. Ensure they understand that it doesn't matter if their predictions turn out to be incorrect. Once the bowl is full or nearly full, children could be encouraged to transfer the water back again using the sponges. If the sponges are still a bit soapy from the first activity, this might create an interesting effect to talk about with the children. Throughout these activities, you can help children use and develop vocabulary relating to capacity: full, half full, nearly full, empty, almost empty, and so on. Have fun with Twinkl resources, and we'll see you soon.